Bob Sampson, nice to meet you. How are you? Bill, how are you?
Bill, how do I get
beautiful day, huh?
Yeah, hold on one second, excuse me.
Go ahead, do your job.
Hi, John.
How are you?
How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm
fine.
Good to see you. You
too. Nice. Hi, Sis. Good. Good to see you. Nice.
Hi.
Got a soft convertible. I said, let's bring that. But my dad's too freaking
cool.
It's not good for hair.
Kim?
Now, wait a minute.
Nice,
Thank you.
In marriage, two persons turn to one another in search of greater fulfillment than either can find alone. Marriage, only in loyalty and devotion bestowed upon another, can that which is most enduring in life be given a chance to emerge in our relationship, and by its quality be fully known. Two among us today, Joe and Claire, come forward to declare their love before us and before God, and to be united in marriage. In this ceremony, we celebrate with them love come to life in their life, and we take a joyful step toward its fulfillment.
Let us pray. Father, you hear our prayers. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Rejoice with those who rejoice, and be sad with those in sorrow. Treat everyone with equal kindness. Never be condescending, but make real friends with the poor. Do not allow yourself to become self-satisfied. Never repay evil with evil, but let everyone see that you're interested only in the highest ideals. Do all you can to live at peace with everyone. This is the word of the Lord.
Responsorial Psalm 145.
And remain in his love. I told you this so that my own joy may be in you, and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
This is the words of Mother Teresa. Do not think that love, in order to be genuine, has to be extraordinary. What we need is to love without getting tired. How does a lamp burn? Through the continuous input of small drops of oil. If the drops of oil run out, the light of the lamp will cease. So the true drops of love. Be faithful in small things, because it is in them that your strength lies.
Another symbol of marriage is the lighting of the unity candle. In this simple ceremony, we will ask Claire and Joe to come forward to lift the two individual side candles in
faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those loved ones who have passed on, especially Alice Valentine Strzok and Alice Cohen, and relatives and friends of all who have joined us today, that they have found eternal peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Who journeyed long distances, including from Alaska, Europe, Wisconsin, and California, and those loved ones who are unable to travel here today, especially the Brannigan family and Edward and Lila Keating, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For personal intentions, which we invite you to contemplate now in silent prayer, we pray to the Lord.
Wants to come with us. He's a friend of Claire's. I am so, of course,
yay, Clemens.
Hey. You might have to say that a couple of times, Joe.
No. Get that camera out, baby.
Am I making you horny?
Let's hear it again, Joe.
I can only say that once, baby. Most of me in the House of Wood. Mrs. Kensington, how does it feel to be Mrs. Croft now?
Hey, George. Could you get me a vodka and orange juice, please? Are you a waiter here?
Well, yes.
I'm
a
Unitarian
minister.
What's she been telling you?
You are the nicest lady.
Your daughter had some sun
wag. Anyone who can drink.
How are you?
Nobody looks better.
Had you had it in London, you would have ran away.
No good.
I got you, babe.
Joe is for 5 or 6 years now, and as I've said before, he's been the best and truest and most loyal friend I could imagine. And then 2 years ago, or almost 2 years ago, I met Claire, and I've seen how much joy she's brought into his life and how much she means to him and what a wonderful future they have together. But what I didn't realize until I came here last night and this week is what a wonderful family they both have. And the thing that struck me is the warmth and the love that comes from the Keatings and the Earleys and the Strupps that's brought them together. And that's something that really strikes me because I have a very small family. It's the immediate family is just my mom and me. And seeing the love and the warmth between the Keatings, Jill and Ellie and Bill and John, and the Earleys, Kevin and Brian, and Tim and Pat, and the Strupps, and Pat, and Michael, and Jim, and Pete, and all of the in-laws and extended families, it's really struck me, and I feel like I've been surrounded by warmth and love, and congratulations to you all.
I've known Joe, how long, 14 years, something like that. And I think at these things, if you've known the groom that long, you're supposed to get up here and tell a couple of stories about him. But I won't do that, because it would just mortify all of you. I mean, I could go into long, long speeches about the Odd Couple television show and all the lines we quote on a daily basis through emails and whatnot, because Joe and I are on opposite coasts. But I won't go through that. What I'll tell you is that for these last 14 years or so, Joe has been my dearest friend for a variety of reasons, mainly because he's just a guy that is so full of love, compassion, and he's so genuine. That how could you not love him? And we may have been separated by a couple of thousand miles over the last several years, but I haven't lost that love. I don't think he has. I certainly hope not. And in recent times, as I've met Claire, I can see why, and very clearly why she is worthy of his love and the crazy, completely consuming love that he feels for her. And maybe a couple of us who know Joe well and have known him for a long time might think, well, how on earth can she feel that kind of love for him? I don't ask that question. I ask, how on earth could she not? And they're two wonderful, wonderful people. Just as Sam so eloquently put, we have a terrific group of people here. Last night, the wonderful time we've had and the time we've had today and will continue to have into the night and tomorrow at brunch, I've come to know you. You're a terrific group of people, both families, the extended family and friends. And this room is just full of loving people and it's just pouring out of all of us. So all I can say is that I love you both, and here's to the next couple of hundred years of love.
I just wanted to add that it's a tribute to Jack and Shotzi and Jim and Margot that they have raised such wonderful, loving families and children.
and Aunt Claire earlier. I certainly didn't want to leave them out because we owe it all to them.
Whoever's father, please show up. stand up. All right, guys, I love you both, and wherever you're watching this, when you watch this, I'm probably thinking about you, so why don't you give me a call?
Ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
phone. And a Joe Gold on the slot trombone. Drummers in the corner with a crash boom, man. Whole rhythm section was a perfect game. Let's rock. Everybody, let's rock. Everybody get a wholesale lock. Days into the jailhouse rock. Sing it. Days into the jailhouse rock.
Lifted me up when I couldn't reach. You gave me
Two, three. get it back on the dance floor.
Straight to my lover's heart for